I've deployed a simple SOA composite application named Say Hello, and I want to create an Oracle Service Bus application that'll virtualize the composite. I start by creating the application, giving it a meaningful name. Then, I create the project within the application. In Service Bus, use folders to organize project files. I create one in my project to store WSDL documents. Service Bus will need a copy of the WSDL for the Say Hello composite to interact with it at runtime. To import the WSDL, I provide the location where the SOA application is deployed, and the wizard retrieves a copy of the file. Service Bus tries to include any dependencies named in any artifacts it imports. Here, the WSDL references a schema file, which is included in the import. Next, I create a business service. The business service defines the endpoint at which the Service Bus application will communicate with the SOA service. This is one place the imported WSDL file will be used. The SOA service communicates with SOAP over HTTP, so to create the business service, I add an HTTP adapter. After naming the service, I associate it with the Say Hello WSDL file. This time, I point to the local copy of the file I imported earlier. The transport and endpoint URI have been automatically filled in. Configuration of the business service is complete. Pipelines define message routing, transformation logic, and other message handling options. A pipeline can be given a meaningful name. Like the business service, the pipeline references the imported WSDL. Creating the pipeline also triggers the creation of a proxy service. The proxy service provides the interface that service consumers use to connect with back-end services through Service Bus. The SOA composite communicates with SOAP over HTTP, but Service Bus can be used to provide a REST interface to the SOA application. Default resource paths and REST operations are defined, but I can edit these defaults or create new ones as needed. The operation binding request can also be tailored. I've given the input parameter a more meaningful name. The response can be tailored too. I've configured the response message to use JSON instead of XML. When the configuration of the REST binding is complete, the application exposes both SOAP and REST interfaces. It's time to test those interfaces. I provide sample input and execute the test. I examine the output. Because it's what I expected, I repeat the process to test the REST interface. I again provide data, and I observe the expected JSON result. Both Service Bus interfaces work as intended. Thank you for watching. For more information, be sure to visit us online